This is the case of a 62 years old female patient that presents with this petroclaval meningioma that is asymptomatic. Options are an anterior petrosectomy or an endoscopic endonasal approach. We perform a preoperative fiber tracking, showing displacement of the oculomotor nerve superiorly and medially, and of the sixth nerve inferiorly. Six nerves here are in yellow, while third nerves are in green, fourth nerves are in red. And the plan is now to do a transcavernous posterior clinoidectomy, for which we need to understand the two layers of the cavernous sinus, because we open the anterior wall while we displace the medial wall, identify the superior hypophyseal artery, remove the posterior clinoid, and this gives us access to the lateral recess of the interpeduncular system. We find the basilar bifurcation and laterally the oculomotor nerve. So here we are opening the anterior wall of the cavernous sinus. Bleeding from the cavernous sinus is easily controlled with gentle packing. This is the superior hypophyseal artery being carefully dissected, now coagulated and transected. This allows us to keep mobilizing the medial wall of the cavernous sinus medially and superiorly. Here we are cutting the fibrous bands of the carotidoclinoidal ligament, and this allows us to keep moving the middle wall of the cavernous sinus medially until we find the posterior clinoid and the interclinoidal ligament. Here is the posterior clinoid being removed. We keep opening the dura around the pituitary gland. Here we coagulate the carotid canal periosteal layer to get extra space. And here we open the dura right where the tumor is arising from. We first coagulate towards the tumor attachment, where the vascular supply is coming from the pitotentorial angle. This is the medial aspect of the tumor being separated from the vascular artery. A pad is protecting the vascular artery, and here we can see how we can work above and below the pituitary gland by means of this pituitary transposition. Here we see the sixth nerve in the bottom of the exposure. We keep dissecting tumor from the lateral aspect, where we find now trigeminal nerve branches. And now we are cutting the tumor away from the oculomotor nerve that is displaced superior and medially, as the fiber tracking pre-op showed us. And this is after complete resection of the tumor. We see sixth nerve on the bottom, SCA and PCA superiorly. That's the fourth nerve up there, and now trigeminal nerve and oculomotor nerve on the top. Reconstruction with DuraGen inlay, now a fasciolata graft onlay, and now our vascularized nasodal flap being restored with Surgicel. And here is the post-op imaging showing a complete resection of the tumor. Patient had an intact pituitary function. And here we can see the correlation of the pre-op HDFT of cranial nerves 3 and 6, and now cranial nerves 4 and 5 with the intraop imaging.